Dr. Scott Brannon. I'm here today to talk to you about diabetes, neuropathy, and peripheral arterial disease. These are all diagnoses that affect the lower extremity. There's relationships between these three diagnoses, and there are differences, and that's what we're going to cover today. Many people recently are familiar with or becoming familiar with the diagnosis of neuropathy. As the diabetic epidemic here in the United States, it grows and begins to manifest its consequences, we're seeing more and more patients that have neuropathy. Now, by the same token, many patients that don't have diabetes also have neuropathy, and we're going to get into that in a moment. So we have a lot of people that are familiar with neuropathy. Most people are familiar with diabetes. But if we look at the diagnosis of peripheral arterial disease, estimates are about 1 in 5 people have ever heard of peripheral arterial disease. And that's an important thing. We need to promote the understanding that these three things are related. And I'll go into detail as to how they're related. So neuropathy, traditionally, we've thought of as a result of diabetes in most cases. And in layman's terms, we think of it as there's a lot of sugar in the blood. The sugar basically gums up the system and the nerves stop working functionally. And that's just about right. Technically, they're called glycosylation end products, and they are like a very, very fine flour that fills in the small arteries that supply the nerves. And that was a good explanation until we looked a little more closely at neuropathy. And what we have discovered recently is that many patients that are not diabetic are presenting with neuropathy. These patients are a group that we call pre-diabetics. They don't have the consistently elevated blood sugar of a type 2 diabetic, but they have episodes of high blood sugar, what we call transient hyperglycemia. And they are presenting with the signs and symptoms of neuropathy before they get the diagnosis of diabetes. We know that diabetes is one of the pathways, the most common pathway to get to neuropathy, but the path that it takes is through PAD, through peripheral arterial disease. Diabetes causes narrowing of micro and macro arteries, the big arteries and the small arteries, and that narrowing and the decrease in blood flow is what leads to ischemia of the nerve. Ischemia meaning low blood flow to the nerve, and that damages the nerve. And we understand now that that's the mechanism whereby neuropathy gets worse. So the relationship there is very well understood. Anybody who has neuropathy, who's older than 55, needs to have a peripheral vascular evaluation because it may be contributing to their disease.